Eclipses are spectacular astronomic events that have been gluing eyes to the skies for millennia. You might know that there are two major kinds, the solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse is what happens when the Earth passes between the sun and the moon. And a solar eclipse is what happens when a celestial dragon devours the sun. Well, that's what people in ancient China claimed, anyway. Their tradition held that a dragon would attack and swallow the sun, but could be driven away by loud noises from the people on Earth. Many cultures believed some supernatural creature was attempting to eat the sun during an eclipse. Lucky for us, they never succeeded. Today we know that a solar eclipse is when the moon passes between the Earth and the sun. Not as interesting as a dragon, of course. The moon's shadow, or umbra, is cast on the Earth, and anyone in the area of the shadow sees an eclipse. And yes, a lunar eclipse is when the Earth passes between the sun and the moon. The Earth casts its shadow on the moon, which makes the moon appear dark from Earth. And you've probably heard of a total eclipse of the sun or the moon, but a total solar eclipse and a total lunar eclipse are actually pretty different. The Earth is a lot bigger than the moon. A lot. So when the moon casts its shadow on the Earth during a solar eclipse, its shadow doesn't fall on the entire planet. Instead, its umbra moves across the Earth. People in the path of the umbra may see a total solar eclipse. People along the edges, though, will only see a partial eclipse. The moon will obscure the sun, but not block it entirely. And in some places, people won't see an eclipse at all. On the other hand, when a total lunar eclipse occurs, where you are on Earth doesn't make much difference. The Earth is so much bigger than the moon that you'll be able to see a total lunar eclipse anywhere on the night side of the Earth while it's happening. But you can still get a partial lunar eclipse. Sometimes the moon passes along the edge of the Earth's shadow, a dim area called the penumbra. There's also a phenomenon known as an annular eclipse. People don't talk about annular eclipses too often, which is too bad because they're awesome. An annular eclipse is a solar eclipse that occurs when the Earth's orbit brings it relatively close to the sun at the same time that the moon's orbit takes it relatively far from the Earth. When that happens, the sun appears larger than the moon in the sky. And so a ring of sunlight is visible around the moon at the height of the eclipse. There are no annular lunar eclipses, because the Earth is so big that its umbra always appears larger than the moon. The moon literally can't get out of the Earth's shadow. So next time you hear about an eclipse on the news, you'll know that in a solar eclipse, the moon passes in front of the sun and casts its shadow on the Earth. In a lunar eclipse, the Earth passes between the sun and the moon, casting its shadow on the moon. But if you want to pretend a celestial dragon is involved, we won't blame you. Stay curious. Subscribe to our channel for more Demystifieds.